See, there's many passages in the Bible that God is only speaking to the prophet. And those passages that he's talking about, that point in that time, he was speaking to the prophet, and he shall reprove the world of sin. So this is where we are. God is the God of power. He is the God of power, and he is a feeling. You can feel him when you got the true Holy Ghost, and that with the mighty burning fire. And just like Romans, the first chapter, and the 20th verse, for the invisible things of him from the creation of the world are clearly seen. And God led me to that, because that's what signs and visions fulfill. The book, he put these things and revealed this general and special revelation all through signs and visions fulfilled, so that it would make people without excuse. That God is trying to bring you somewhere. The door is open now. He's calling his sheep to come in. So he put all these things in this book with the scripture, because without the scripture, you have no foundation. God have to line that up. Man can't do that. Man have his way. But who weighs right, man or God? God weighs always right. And there's a verse in the Bible speaks of that. Proverbs 14 and 12. There's a way that seemeth right unto man, but therein at the end there is death. There's death, because it's not his way, it's God's way. So that's why the Bible speaks of return unto him, because they got off track and they got away from the commandments and the teaching of God in his kingdom. So clearly seen, being understood by things that are made, even his eternal power and Godhead, so that they are without excuse. Romans 1 and 20. See, there's no excuse that is there. So that's why God said that the hard head and the stubbornness and the goat head and the stiff necked people, he said that's why the separation that he gonna do. He's going to put the sheep on the right hand and the goats on the left. And there's going to be casting out into the lake of fire. Believe me, it's been time to get serious with your life, ladies and gentlemen and boys and girls. They didn't believe then how God was. Everybody talking about God is a good God. He's good all the time. Well, they must don't see what's going on in the world, because the dust doesn't just flare up on his own. God made good and he created evil. God is a God of peace and a man of war. So when you don't obey him, he does these things to get your attention. So all of the things that's off course, it happened before, but in the last days, never before happened like it's going to happen in the last days. So you have many, as Jesus said, have went out and to deceive many people using swelling words, fair speech. You know, it's not of fair speech. It's not of that, but by power. So that's what Jesus was saying when people and all through the Bible had got off course. That's why God said, return unto me and I will return unto you. But he had to send somebody for there to help us in these times, because he said, without a prophet in the land of his prophet, the land will perish. So you have to have a true prophet of God with the true gospel of Jesus Christ. And every word that come out of the mouth of man is not of God. So that's why we're dividing the truth from a lie. God have made this after 7 years, this great book, Signs and Visions Fulfilled. He made this after 7 years so you can get a clear understanding and what his kingdom and where his power is and what's going on by the work's sake, with evidence, not just with evidence, but with results is what you get the truth of the true gospel of Jesus Christ.